Hi, I'm Alicia Wong, the pastry chef of Nesuto Patisserie and also one of the co-founder of Nesuto Patisserie. I'm an alumni of At-Sunrice Global Chef Academy. Nesuto means home. Yeah, it means home in Japanese. The reason why I want to open up Nesuto is because I thought and I still believe in it that we could help people who want to become chef not just learn skills that are kitchen related but also life skill. I really want a kitchen to be a place of like character development. Pastry and dessert don't have to be something that is super exquisite. It could be even like back to the days whereby, you know, like after dinner, if your grandma offers you a kueh or ice cream, so it could be as simple as that. So something very comforting, I think, yeah, to finish off a meal. So a few of our top bestsellers, which are actually flavours that are not difficult to guess. They are not like some crazy, like innovative flavours. We have like the yuzu raspberry. Yuzu because it's like a bit citrusy, and sometimes sweet as well. And we realised that, okay, customers, you know, they always complain, oh, like desserts also sweet, I don't like it. So we thought we're going to do a dessert that is not sweet, but instead it's sour. It's more like a palate cleanser. When they enjoy the dessert, they're like, oh wow, like this is such a palate cleanser. And we also have a few bestsellers, like we have the Logoma cake, which is Japanese black sesame cake. To be honest, I'm not a fan of black sesame because I think black sesame desserts I've eaten since young, like the traditional one, is very strong. But this black sesame is different. So it's very light, it's very delicate, but at the same time, it's very roasted flavor. So this is one of the cakes that caters to people of older crowd. It's something that they can relate to because it's traditional desserts, black sesame paste. But it's something that they can also enjoy. So that's how Nesuto become popular. We try to cater to everybody of different palate. Even with being in school for 17 months, there's only so much that you can learn. But that's really my training ground for Capella, and I was there for 6 years. I think one of the more scary experiences that I had was, I think we had a buffet for 300, 400 people. So we had like three full trolleys full of decorated buffet items, desserts already. As we push a trolley out, we're about to set up, the whole trolley collapsed on us. So that's when I really see like my pastry chef then, she was very calm. She's like, okay, let's not panic, you know. The first thing to do is never panic, whenever if there's an emergency. And to really think calmly, what's the next that we could do. Continuous learning, I think, is very important. Resilience, all of these are things that you have to bear in mind wherever you go. And even with how many years of experience, never get complacent in what you do. If you give 17 of your months to this, right, then it has to be something that you have really committed your life to already. Yeah, and it's definitely fulfilling.